tonight, thousands are gathered in protest of Enbridge's Line 3 pipeline, and Enbridge is responding as the project enters a final phase of construction. Plus, local businesses are hoping to brew up change when it comes to Minnesota's liquor laws. And no one left behind. That's the goal of a new partnership aiming to ensure local veterans have a place to call home.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 6.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke. Thanks for joining us. A huge group of protesters gathered today for what organizers called the largest rally against the Line 3 replacement project yet. About 2,000 people with environmental and tribal groups set up a blockade at the entrance to an Enbridge Energy pump station near Park Rapids. Dozens reportedly chained themselves to construction equipment. Enbridge also told us they had to evacuate 44 workers in that area. Today's protest comes as Enbridge gears up for a final construction push on its pipeline, which carries crude oil from Canada to Superior. Opponents claim the pipeline could harm the environment, where Native Americans gather wild rice, hunt, fish, and claim treaty rights. Actress and activist Jane Fonda was among the protesters today. She says they will keep calling on President Joe Biden to halt construction.
We have to raise a ruckus and make it as difficult as possible for Enbridge Line 3 at every single river crossing.
The state gave Enbridge the final go-ahead for the replacement project back in December after years of regulatory review. They got to work right away and now are about 60% finished with the Minnesota section. Today, Enbridge leaders told us worker and surrounding community safety is their top priority.
We have thousands of Minnesotans who support this project, you know, and thousands of Minnesotans who are working and benefiting from this opportunity, particularly at a time where, you know, COVID hit northern Minnesota's economy really hard.
Both sides are also waiting for a major ruling from the Minnesota Court of Appeals later this month. We'll continue following this story and bring you any updates as they come in. Firefighters are trying to stop a Boundary Waters wildfire from spreading any further. The Hassel Lake fire is currently 3 acres and 0% contained. The Forest Service says it started late Friday, likely from a lightning strike. It's burning about 10 miles northeast of Tower. Fire crews are still working to find an access route to fight the flames on the ground. Currently, they are dropping water from the air. The fire forced the closure of lakes, campsites, and portages in the BWCA west of Crab Lake. Dave joins us now for a quick look at the weather. Dave, is there going to be any relief in sight for that high fire danger?
Well, there's a slight chance up in that neck of the woods for some rain tonight, but there's also the threat of lightning, which may start more fires. And bottom line is, humidity levels are awfully dry, so the fire danger is very high in Minnesota, especially near critical fire conditions here tonight, at least through sunset. So, yeah, mind your P's and Q's outside with fire. The fire danger in Wisconsin right now is moderate, and it's high in the Upper Peninsula, so it's up there for everybody. And as always, the solution remains rain, and there is a chance for some rain, especially near the Canadian border tonight as an upper-level trough of lower pressure works through the area. The odds of payoff for northern Minnesota are about 50-50 as clouds increase tonight, leading us to a 50% chance in Minnesota for showers and thunderstorms tomorrow, 30% chance for Wisconsin and Michigan. But it's not the only chance for precip here this week. Temperatures will slowly dial down, though initially they're going to stay fairly warm. We'll talk about the temperature trends and the precip chances in more detail in a few more minutes.
All right, thanks, Dave. Minnesota's liquor laws are hurting small businesses. That's according to some local business owners who are pushing lawmakers to make a change. CBS 3's Emma Quinn spoke with a local brewery owner and lawmakers about what they want to see happen.
For roughly 2 years, Ben Hugis has been busy brewing at Ursa Minor in the Lincoln Park neighborhood.
We've been following the industry for a lot longer than that. As far as liquor laws and how they've affected our business, they've changed a little bit in recent decades.
But Hugis says current Minnesota liquor laws haven't evolved with the changing industry.
Something that we're not allowed to do is we're not allowed to sell 4-packs or 16-ounce or 12-ounce cans in our tap rooms.
He says this has hurt, especially as tap rooms have grown in popularity.
The liquor store next door, you could buy anything you want, but you can't buy it here. There's all these subtle laws like that, where in all the surrounding states around us, you can.
Now, local lawmakers are hoping the Drink Local Economic Recovery Package will help Minnesota's craft brewery industry. Duluth Representative Liz Olson, a DFLer, co-authored that bill, which she says has received bipartisan support.
It is rural districts, it is urban districts, it is very progressive legislators, it is very conservative legislators. And the will of the caucus has to be reflected at some point.
The new bill would allow liquor stores, bars, and restaurants to fill growlers to go. Restaurants would be able to permanently allow cocktails to go, and growler limits would be lifted on craft breweries of a certain size.
We'd be able to brew larger batches of more experimental beers, and we could, or smaller. You know, having alternate ways to sell something and getting it into homes.
During a rally at the state capitol Monday morning, Olson said these new laws could help businesses grow economically.
I am really proud to see this coalition come together. I am really proud to see the work. And I think what we have done is do a really good job of not looking back, but looking forward and talking about what is yet to come.
Republican Representative Jim Nash from Waconia also supports the bill and spoke at the rally. The bill is expected to be heard during the upcoming special session, which starts on Monday. Duluth City Trails and shore erosion control are some big-ticket items on tonight's City Council agenda. The council is expected to clarify its priorities when it comes to upcoming trail projects. A resolution explains the city is prioritizing restoration and repairs on the scenic Duluth, Winnipeg, and Pacific Railroad Corridor Trail. Duluth's Cross City Trail is also undergoing a project. The trail system connects the Lake Walk to the Munger Trail. It will be designed to become a multi-purpose wheelchair accessible area. The council will also discuss an ordinance that would give shoreline property owners an easement, allowing for them to double down on erosion control. During tonight's Committee of the Whole meeting, the council will also discuss how to distribute $60 million in federal COVID relief money. That meeting started at 5:15. The regular council meeting begins at 7. We'll have more details from both meetings tonight at 10. We are now taking a live look at the Capitol in Madison, where today Wisconsin's Governor Tony Evers announced his bid for a second term in the battleground state. Evers currently stands as a lame duck, meaning he's a Democrat with a Republican-controlled state legislature. Evers said he decided to run again because he has unfinished business. The first 2.5 years of his term have been marked by clashes with the GOP-led legislature. Several Republicans are considering running against him. The governor's seat will be on the ballot in November of 2022. A new partnership aims to help veterans right here in the Twin Ports. Duluth PAC has teamed up with Operation Hat Trick, an organization that gives back to veterans across the nation. Duluth PAC will sell OHT bags, and the proceeds will support our local chapter of MACV, which aims to end veteran homelessness throughout Minnesota. MACV leaders say this money will go a long way.
There's so much support to help veterans. It's a pride thing. You know, as veterans, veteran myself, it's great to see our city and our community stand up and help out.
The new Operation Hat Trick packs are on sale on the Duluth PAC website. After being closed for 15 months due to the pandemic, the Duluth Public Library reopened its doors today. Some things have changed. A few sections have shifted, and they've added a greeter station to help people adjust to being back in the building. There will be no capacity limits, but they will continue to encourage wearing masks. The library will also continue its curbside option to pick up materials. Library manager Carla Powers says while a few things may look different, they are just excited to welcome back visitors.
Already today, just on this first day, it feels completely different to have the public in the building. We're able to help them and just, you know, have the energy in the building again after so many months of just the staff in here.
We have the main branch's hours on our website. They will also have information on their summer programming on site. And staying in Duluth, the Benedictine Living Community reopened a program aimed at helping the elderly socialize. The Adult Day Service program has been on a hiatus for more than a year due to the pandemic. The program is offered 5 days a week and provides a safe setting to mingle and learn. Program reps say they have missed the participants, and they say they're excited to once again care for older adults who need assistance during the day. A Minnesota family is grieving the loss of their 14-year-old son after he was shot and killed while leaving a graduation party in a St. Paul neighborhood. The shooting took place on Saturday night around 11 p.m. The boy's mother said three males pulled guns on her son and his older brother as they were leaving, then opened fire on the back of their car. Investigators found several neighboring homes with bullet holes, but no other injuries were reported. One longtime resident said gun violence needs to stop.
We've been here 30 years, yeah. And nothing like this ever happened.
Never. Okay.
So I feel sorry for the neighbors, yeah. And us. So it's a sad day. Somebody shot. It has to stop.
So far, no arrests have been made. The family says they hope people at the graduation party will come forward to tell police who fired the shots. Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, with the tourism season starting off with a bang, some locals are trying to get a piece of the action with a new adventurous business.
Rain hasn't done much here in June. We're a week into the month, and for the Twin Ports, 0.06 of an inch, almost an inch shy for rain totals. We'll try to catch up as the week goes on, but it looks like an iffy process. We'll talk about the odds of a preset payoff and, of course, the temperature trends for the next 7 days coming up after the break.
CBS 3 News is brought to you by ServiceMaster.
What does home mean to you? From graduation to the new job to sharing a life with someone else. As you change, so does your idea of home. Visit yournorthlandhome.com for comprehensive information on buying and selling your home with JS Realty, including mistakes buyers make and preparing your home to sell. Yournorthlandhome.com has the information you need to find a place that feels like home. Download your free guide today at yournorthlandhome.com.
Menards has the flooring you need to give your home a fresh look. Check out our great selection of Shaw flooring. Add warmth with soft and luxurious carpet. Durable laminate flooring is easy to install. Waterproof vinyl plank is perfect for active lifestyles. Or if tile is more your style, Mohawk porcelain or ceramic tile adds timeless beauty to any room. Right now, all flooring is 11% off at Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
You need fast, reliable internet, but it's not a one-size-fits-all world. At Mediacom, we have a price and plan for everyone. You can get our starting internet service for $19.99 a month for a year. And with that comes a great deal of speed. We're talking 60 meg, because unlike other providers, we want you to have fast internet from the start. Extreme speeds go up to 1 gig with lots of options to choose from. So let's talk. Call us today at 844-EXTREME-2.
Jim Pearl Construction has been awarded the title of Authorized Replacement Contractor by the Marvin Window and Door Company. This entitles us to give better pricing and longer warranties on Marvin's high-quality windows and doors. We are the only authorized replacement contractor in the Northland. This caps off our 49 years of being your professional, dependable, and honest home improvement contractor. Please call us for any of your home improvement needs.
Be when you grow up?
I want to be a janitor that cleans the world.
How much does a janitor that cleans the world make?
If you clean like 100 buildings a day, you'd probably get paid like $300.
You in the ballpark? What age do you think is a good time to move out of your parents' house?
26.
26? Good Lord, I ain't never leaving.
Tiffany Haddish hosts a new Kids Say the Darndest Things Wednesday at 8, 7 Central, or stream anytime on CBS.
Get your news on the go, the CBS 3 mobile app. Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Well, as long as we're talking about warm temperatures, we also have to talk about dew points, because where the dew point is a good indicator of comfort levels. And bottom line, with the dew point, which is a good indicator of humidity, if you're in the 50s or lower, it's pretty comfortable. You get into the 60s towards the 70s, then it gets pretty sticky. So most of us have been able to tolerate this warm spell because you see a dew point of only 37 in Orr, 36 in Ely. 50 in Hibbing isn't doing too bad. 46 in Ashland, it's fairly comfortable as well. Superior's in that range. But then it goes to 66 in Moose Lake, 68 Solon Springs, 67 Hayward, and even 61 Watersmeet. 60s and 70s are pretty sticky. And so temperatures will stay up for a couple more days, and dew points likely will continue to follow that trend of being tolerable up north and a little bit more humid down south. Good luck to everybody, depending on your opinion of heat and humidity, of course. Well, that humidity and some of that heat will try to drive some thunderstorms tonight, but they'll be doing so in the zone with the lower dew points, which doesn't really support the formation of thunder. That's why it's less than a 50% chance for a lot of towns. Anyway, into the current conditions. 82 at the airport, 35% for the relative humidity, which, of course, is bringing its own troubles. Low relative humidity in Minnesota is leading to some pretty high fire dangers. Easterly, southeasterly winds going 10 miles per hour, and our air pressure 29.82 inches of mercury. And with that lower pressure system slated to run across the border tonight, barometer readings likely will go down. Temperature readings should go down a little bit as well, and they're still pretty warm. 87 Watersmeet, 85 Hayward, 85 towards Hibbing. A bit cooler by the lake, 80 for LaPointe, 76 for Ashland. Lows tonight likely will fall towards 60 for most towns. High pressure has a hold of us right now, so the sky is sunny and conditions are dry. But we're eyeing up an upper level trough of lower pressure that is to our northwest, and this is what's going to ride along the Canadian border, bringing a chance for showers and thunderstorms and maybe even some severe ones here from International Falls and through the Cook Orr region and towards Bike and Crane Lake, Ely, Isabella, exiting towards Grand Marais, Grand Portage overnight here tonight. 50% chance that could happen. 30% chance for rain for the rest of our area, which may not add up to much at all. If it pays off up north, maybe a tenth to a quarter of an inch, and maybe just some sprinkles then for the rest of us. But there are more rain chances this week. Tonight in Minnesota, there's your low temps towards 60, with clouds increasing after midnight. And they'll increase in Wisconsin and Michigan as well, with lows there from 58 to 65. Tomorrow, Wisconsin, Michigan high temps should go from 79 by the lake to 90 inland. 30% storm chance. 40% shot for the storms tomorrow through early afternoon Minnesota. 70s by the lake, upper 80s inland. So the warming trend continues. Probably through Wednesday or Thursday, then it starts to fall off a little bit for a couple of days. Bottom line is Twin Ports numbers should go 75 to 80 for highs, maybe 80, 85 farther inland, low temps in the 50s, and another rain chances with us for Thursday and Friday.
Thanks, Dave. Summer is a busy tourism season for the Northland, and businesses are always looking for ways to appeal to visitors. As CBS3's Kendall Jarbo shows, there's a new adventure company on Lake Superior created to connect both tourists and locals to the outdoors.
There's no shortage of outdoor activities in the Northland, but some don't know where to start. That's why Zenith Adventure in Duluth is launching a new service for the area, Sunrise Paddleboard Tours.
So we're really excited to take people in the bay, through the canal, and we specialize in sunrise sunset because typically that's what a lot of people don't want to do alone.
Group tours bringing together both locals and tourists, a long-awaited venture after a year spent apart.
Well, I'm really excited. I think that there's going to be a lot of energy down here in Canal Park. I think there's going to be a lot of people wanting to be a part of a group this summer.
Sunrise paddleboard tours aren't the only excursion Zenith Adventure is offering this summer. They'll have kayak rentals later in the summer. Paddleboard tours go through August. Plenty of time for anyone to give it a try.
You totally can do it. You can sit however is comfortable, but like only do what you're comfortable and happy doing, because it's like an experience and it means something different to everybody else.
Northland natives and out-of-state travelers connected through the big lake.
People are excited to connect, they're excited to get together, and I don't think there's a better way to do that than get out on Lake Superior. So yeah, we expect it to be busy, we're excited, and we're ready.
Sunrise Paddleboard Tours will officially launch on July 2nd. Paddleboard rentals are happening right now. To book your spot, we have a link at cbs3duluth.com. Coming up in sports, bring on the baseball. Wade Stadium prepares to welcome back fans. Kelly is in next.
You're on the boat at RJ Sports.
CBS 3 Live Cams, brought to you by KohlerChev.com. Now featuring the Kohler Express Deal online buying solution. KohlerChev.com, a better way to buy.
Numi Jewelers is excited to announce our spectacular 70th anniversary sale. For the month of June, save up to 70% on select jewelry. Celebrate 70 years with us. Stop in to browse our huge selection. True love is guaranteed at Numi Jewelers.
They're only going to graduate once, which means this is your only chance to get this right. Are you worried? Of course not. When the pressure is on, you know where to turn. Super One has you covered for all your grad party needs. Our fresh fruit, deli party favorites, and handcrafted baked goods are sure to impress. So sit back and get this party started. Super One Foods, helping you bring family and friends together for over 40 years.
We can help you at Ketamine North Infusion Center.
In public safety, we see things that sometimes you can't unsee. After these infusions, everything just kind of turned around and I was able to start enjoying things again.
To learn more, give us a call or visit us online.
Hi, John with Prime Appliance. Our summer sizzler sale's on now. While the temperature is rising, the prices are dropping on all appliances and air conditioning.
Get a Frigidaire 5000 BTU window air conditioner for just $167, or this GE 5 cubic foot chest freezer for just $263. Find Whirlpool 18 cubic foot top mount refrigerators for just $749 in white and $798 in stainless. Financing always available. Have our pros deliver and install or take it home today. Prime Appliance is the best place to buy your appliances. Let us prove it to you.
Go on, get off the ladder, and place it back where you found it. The days of dangerous climbs are over. Gutter Helmet provides year-round protection, preventing buildup of debris, keeping your gutters clear and free-flowing. With its heavy-duty support brackets and exclusive Helmet Heat Ice Reduction System, Gutter Helmet's been designed to withstand the harshest weather conditions. Get Gutter Helmet, America's number one choice for gutter protection. And never clean your gutters again.
If you haven't seen United States of Al, we want you.
Mr. Walmir Karimi fought alongside our men and women. Take a picture. And now with Mr. Art.
All right, that's enough.
Wait, we need Lizzie. I did not seek fame, but it seems to have found me.
A new United States of Al, Thursday after Young Sheldon, or stream anytime on CBS.
Being challenged by DFL.
The race is on. Learn how Berkey 2021
is it safe to be ice fishing on Lake Superior?
New funding is bringing more mental health resources.
Meteorologist Dave Anderson.
How a popular new recreational area is allowing.
Hear how one vaccination clinic in West Duluth is focusing.
We're into the COVID-19 pandemic and food insecurity is still
new year, new ownership.
To stay up to date with the news and weather that impacts you and your community, join us weekdays for CBS 3 Live at 5.
The CBS Evening News with Nora O'Donnell. Weeknights on CBS.
Now, CBS 3 Sports with Kelly Hinson.
While the Huskies look to turn around their rough start to the 2021 season, they're turning around some of their COVID-19 protocols at Wade Stadium. Starting tomorrow night against the La Crosse Loggers, their mandatory mask mandate will be lifted, and they will officially welcome 100% fan capacity back to the ballpark. Currently, the Huskies are only allowing 900 total fans with 150 in each section. Maximum capacity at Wade Stadium is just over 3,300 people. And General Manager Greg Culver says they have had zero cases of COVID-19 linked to Wade Stadium. And they also hope to resume walk-up food and drink services by June 24th. It was not so great news for Boston this past weekend, an underwhelming performance against the New York Islanders in Game 4. But good news is it makes room for an Esko native on the third line. Carson Kuhlman is in for tonight's Game 5. Kuhlman finished with an assist in Boston's Game 2 overtime loss to the Islanders at TD Garden while playing in the place of injured Craig Smith. But this time, the nod is strictly performance-based.
If he brings high energy, he gets his feet moving. I think the first game he was in, there was some
apprehension about how much time and space he had. It's going to be a physical series, has been a physical series. So, you know, sometimes you need some shifts under your belts. And I thought as the game went on, he got better. So good play away from the puck. Again, help us win.
Bruins face the Islanders for game 6 tonight at 6:30 p.m. The old saying goes, a playoff series doesn't start until a road team wins a game. That's the opportunity the Bucks will have tonight. Milwaukee is in Brooklyn for game 2 against the Nets. They dropped their first game of the playoffs, 115-107 on Saturday. They didn't shoot the ball all that well, just 20% from 3, well below their season average. The Bucks know that they have a big opportunity in front of them with Nets all-star guard James Harden ruled out for game 2 after he aggravated his hamstring injury in game 1.
That's disappointing. You never want to lose, but it happens in the sport. But at the same time, we got to keep our focus maintained, not hang our heads too low for a game 1 loss, only one game. Just come out, compete, and win. You know, they got the first game at their home. We got to try to get one, and we got to try to get this next one for sure. To even out going back home, the same approach, but just know we got to lay it all out there on the line. We got to play better than we did in game 1.
And while there is no official guarantee that the Olympics in Tokyo will go on this summer, we're just 46 days away from the scheduled opening ceremonies. And Team USA superstar Simone Biles further solidified her status as the greatest American gymnast ever last night. She prepares to represent the Stars and Stripes. Biles earned her 7th straight all-around title at last night's U.S. Gymnastics Championships. The 24-year-old has won every all-around event she's entered since 2013, including gold at the 2016 Rio Olympics. Can't think of any athletic endeavor that I've been that good at since.
The epitome of an Olympian.
The GOAT.
Yes. Thank you, Kelly. Yeah. We'll leave you with this sweet story out of Eveleth, where first responders weren't too busy to fulfill a classic duty, rescuing a cat from a tree. Earlier in the day, Eveleth EMS responded to a call from a West Eveleth resident who said they could hear a cat crying in a tree, and they were worried it was stuck. The Eveleth Ambulance Service responded to the scene with a ladder. The cat was safely rescued and returned to its home. Oh, I love a feel-good story like that.
Yeah, I wonder if they have classes at LSC Fire School for getting cats out of trees.
Getting cats out of trees.
That's a pretty good school.
It is, and I feel like that is a classic tale, right?
Mm-hmm. A lot of those firefighters back in the day took weather classes from me, learning how to swing slingshikrometers here instead of cats, so they could calculate the dew point. And like we talked about earlier, the dew point's on the lower side, so as warm as it isn't as uncomfortable as it could be, but it's still going to stay fairly warm for the rest of the week. By the lake here, about 75 to 80, probably at least 80 to 85 farther inland. There is a rain chance tonight through tomorrow, especially up north near the Canadian border. And if that doesn't bring enough rain, and it probably won't, we have another chance Thursday and Friday.
Thanks for joining us. We'll see you at 10.